Hi, my name is Sandy. I work at the West Shreveport Library for Shreve Memorial Library, and I want to do a DIY paper rose tutorial for June because it's National Rose Month and it's a big wedding month. A lot of people can't afford flowers, real flowers, and so this is an alternative to decorate for your wedding. First, I have three patterns for three different size petals, small, medium, and large. It takes 8 to make the inside of the rose. It takes 12 for the medium, and it takes 6 for the large, but you can add more if you want it. Then you have to curl the, it's made with cardstock. This is just regular cardstock. And you have to curl the petals. You can use anything that's round. I use this huge pencil, and you just pull it like that, and it rounds your petals. So first you want to take, to save time, I went ahead and did, I hot glued these, 4 of them together. You take 4. After you get 4, this is for the bud part of the rose, and then you put hot glue here and hot glue here on the opposite side. And you want to bring them together if you can do it without burning yourself. And it makes a nice little pyramid. And you have to kind of hold it till the glue sets. Okay. And you do it on the opposite ones. Want that hot glue to set. Oh, I think I did that wrong side on the outside. Okay. I don't recommend children doing this because that hot glue is hot. You can get burned. I always get burned every time I use hot glue. And I'm an adult. And you have to hold it till it sets. That's the first 4. Then you do that again. You want your petals rolled up for this inside part. Glue to this. Put this in the middle and you do it all over again. This, by the way, is the finished product. So you can see what it's going to look like. Stick. beginning to make them a little looser. You want them to gradually start opening up. Now the next step, you use the medium ones. Let's see here, I've got some already curled. You want to go in the, you want to turn your petals the opposite direction. In other words, these went inward. Now we want them to go outward. So, and when you do this, you want to put your index finger on the inside, your thumb, and the third finger on the outside, and you want to pull it up like this and attach. So, you want to leave that a big gap, but it'll be all right. Hopefully, if I can get this one to do right. See how it's, I'm starting to open it up where it's coming more outward. This next step, oh, that's large. Did I pull that from over here? No, that's medium. Okay. I want to make sure I'm going to use medium right now. until this point, I've gone back and forth like a cross. Now we want to go in the middle between those. Right, and we just keep building. Curled real good. You want to start curling them a little more as it comes out too. You can really use anything to curl this cardstock. It's easy, but I find it works good with something round. Some people use a butter knife. I mean, you can invest in that bone thing, but why when you have something else at home that'll work? And it's not holding. Come on, hot glue, quit. Stick. Not gonna stick. Okay, let me see if I can do this side. I'm not gonna do that one. That one came totally off. Wow. Okay. Anyway, you just keep going like this till you're finished. And then I added some leaves because I just thought it needed leaves. That's what I used with my scraps of my cardstock. I don't like to throw anything away if I didn't use it. So anyway, that's how you do it. I hope y'all have fun. Bye.